It's the biggest musical competition in the country, where dreams are made or broken.
I love in the movie that everyone kind of has the thing that defines it, their own personal taste. You know, you like Evil Dead 2, which I think is awesome. Will likes, he quotes Pink Floyd, which I think is really cool. Yeah. Well, what are some things that you guys had that kind of, that are your own things, your own movies or music that kind of just define who you are?
I think my giggle defines who I am. I'm just an extremely happy, outgoing, kind of free spirit, all over the place person that I'm laughing all the time, and it makes me a happy person. I think it makes people around me happy as well. Yeah. So that's me.
Take that.
I think the books that I read define me because I'm like a major bookworm. I was like the Sam during takes on set reading all the time. But probably the books that I read, and it's really weird. Gaelan mentioned this. He said, whenever I laugh, I close my eyes.
It's true.
It's so weird. And he mentioned it to me. I was like, that's such a weird thing for you to pick up. He's like, yeah, he always goes.
But so, he knows it. So it's one of those things.
Yeah, it's one of those, like, it's like you. A little, it's an alleyism.
Right.
You know?
So from now on, anytime I see anyone close their eyes,
I'm going to go,
I'm gonna go, that's been done before.
It's so been done. So it's not very original.
How big is this whole band slam thing around here?
Texas high school football big. Keep it hot like steam. That's your dream, baby. What's your name?
Will Burton. What's yours?
The Five is silent.
Now, I love Sam with the five, and then the five is silent. So I was going to ask your opinion. I went ahead, and I have my name on a sheet of paper.
It.
Well, I was going to ask what you think. I have my name. Ooh. I have Jake. It took me a long time to make this. And I was going to see where you thought, like, which number I should be. I have a little pin.
I think you should be number seven popped in my head.
Well, I said eight, because Jake, eight. Jake, the eight is silent.
So where would it be? I'm gonna give you this. Okay. See where you think
or
it should
do
be.
Seven.
Where on that?
Jake,
where you think it
seven.
Should be?
No, I like eight.
You like eight?
Like eight. Okay. So it's maybe like between the K and the E, like an eight right there.
Yeah.
Kate. I like it.
Kate. Yeah.
I like
it.
Cool. So from now on, all the next time you see me.
Love it.
I'm Charlotte. Nice to meet you.
I've known you since fifth grade.
Oh.
It's a night that belongs to only the best.
The winner gets an actual record deal.
Sweet.
I'm starting a band.
And a few who don't know better.
He's a paper boy. You know he's crook. He likes the girls. The got the junk.
It's embarrassing.
How many times have we watched a movie about high school and you see those cliches, but you wonder, where did that stereotype come from?
Right,
because,
exactly.
I mean, in 4 years of high school, I'm not quite sure I ever experienced this moment or that
There's like,
and it went
there's
the wrong
one
way.
Scene that exemplifies it where Scott Porter's character, he looks at his friends and he's like, look, can you guys like figure out what the deal is with this kid? And his friends kind of look at each other and look at him and go, dude, we're your friends, man. We don't like work for you, man.
Absolutely.
You
know, and it's like the Joker's
henchman. Yeah, in a normal movie. typical high school teen movie, they'd be like, great, you know, montage sequence. But they're like, dude.
And you just, how refreshing is that?
Yeah, no, it is. It really is. I mean, it just felt very real when you're reading it. It's like, ooh, wow, look at that. He just said that. And, oh, she actually did that.
And so easy to make a high school movie that's so black and white. Like, the cheerleader, like, is all this, and there's McLovin in this corner, you know? And this movie's not like that. There's so many more, every character has so much more gray area, which is what high school is.
Right.
You don't actually have, like, this guy, like Hollywood says, who does everything.
Absolutely.
And I think that's why this movie is so relatable.
I think if you tried signaling, people would honk less.
They don't need to know my business.
It's not really a privacy issue. It seems like you're trying way too hard to be Flea from the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
I don't even like Flea.
Yeah, what's your name? Bug?
That's what it's like. That's real. That's genuine.
Yeah.
That's the 4 years of high school. Now, I love that you guys shot in Austin, right? I mean, Austin's such a music-oriented city. I mean, was that cool to be able to add that element, especially to this movie, to really just throw that element in there?
Yeah, go ahead.
It was awesome. We shot
happening.
It right with South by Southwest,
right.
Which, I mean, you're shooting a movie about music. South by Southwest is happening. You can't ask for, I mean,
right.
I guess you could ask for kissing the two lead actresses.
Up.
And then, it was very lucky. Lucky streak I'm on right now.
You're managing a band.
I know. It's uncharted territory. And
I will be. All the odds are against them.
You guys are going up against Glory Dogs.
This is crazy.
It's time to step aside.
Do you have a head injury?
Holla.
All they need is each other.
What are the early warning signs of a heart attack?
You gotta go for it. Carpe diem.
Do the thing that scares you.
So I'd love that this movie takes every cliche that it could have been and goes the opposite direction. Because every time I thought I had it figured out, it went a different way. Was that cool to read the script and go, oh my God, it's another one of these characters? Yeah. And you go, wait, maybe it's not.
It's
one
not.
Of those
and the ending is not, you know, a typical ending. And I feel like the characters themselves go through an arc, go through a change and a journey. And a lot of characters sometimes just stay the same, or they're still the mean girl, or they're still the girl who's shy, and they're still the one who's in their shell. But in these movies, like, our characters kind of come to know who they are as people and you know, change and have feelings. And there's emotion in this film. You know, it's a drama, but it's also a comedy.
Michalka, Vanessa Hudgens, Gaelan Connell, and Lisa Kudrow.
She pretty?
Inappropriate! We are not having this discussion now.
You like her, like her.
Shut up.
You kissed her yet?
I wouldn't even know what to do.
Start by gently moving a strand of hair from her face. Nice.
Bandslam.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
It's cute.